Today's question reads, how do you deal with anger coming out from under the daily pressures of being a mom and a wife? Especially as a child of God, you want desperately to be Jesus to them. Ooh, child, I can relate to this, let me tell you. You know what? First, let's talk about what is anger. Anger is violated rights, a feeling of your rights being violated. So let's deal with, what rights do you feel are being violated in your role as a mom, as a wife? Lack of appreciation, consideration, sensitivity to your needs. All of these things fall on that list of mom and wife. What exactly is it that you feel you are not getting from your husband, from your children? And if you're not a mom and a wife, this question is a broad question. What do you feel you're not getting from your friends, family members, coworkers? It all is the same thing across the board. Anger is when we feel that our rights are violated. What do you feel entitled to? Let's begin there. And then let's surrender that entitlement, because it's important for us to know that we come to the earth as servants. Jesus came as a servant, we are servants. And so whether we get the appreciation or not, the thank yous, even the acknowledgments of what's done, it should not affect our heart condition. But this is where the enemy comes in, and he plays with our minds mentally. He plays with us and he questions us about, don't you think you deserve better than that? And yeah, the question is, we do, but sometimes we don't get what we deserve, and we have to look at the hand of God for all rewards that come to us. So it is so important when we're angry to surrender the rights that we feel are not being given to us. And then to retreat to a place of servanthood in our hearts. Surrender those feelings to God. Let him know how you feel. Say, God, I don't feel appreciated. I don't feel that people are being sensitive to my needs. Give it to him and allow him to fill those empty places with himself. Release them from the obligation to give you what you feel you deserve, and open your hands for God to fill and reward as he deems best. That way your joy level is never affected, and you're free and liberated to continue giving, continue serving, continue showing Christ to others, even when they're being ungrateful. Now on the practical side of life, express yourself in love, not while you're angry. Count to 10, breathe in deeply, get to a place of calm, and then make your needs known to the person that you feel is not being considerate, or whatever it is that's caused you to be angry. But also examine what you need from that person so that you go with a solution, not just a problem. Help them help you. In most cases, if they knew better, they would do better. So help them do better by giving them tips on how they can make life better for both of you together. Can we really be Jesus to anyone? We can try, but only Jesus can be Jesus. We represent Jesus, and yes, we are supposed to look like him, but we do that and grow from glory to glory in that. So I think that staying vulnerable and expressing your needs to the other person helps them to understand where you are. And above all things, you still have to release it back to God. Hey, if I've managed to bless you today, why not subscribe and share this with someone else? Someone else needs to be blessed. Don't forget to follow me on my other platforms as well, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. See you there.